Welcome. It's the thrilling and exciting day of getting to solve log equations. Of course, since you've been through this before, it's now going to be a snap. As you may recall, when we work with logarithms and we work with equations that have more than one logarithm in them, there are three exciting properties of logarithms that basically do all the work for us. So, of course, you may look at this first one and go, the log base m plus the log base n of is going to be equal to, and I'm looking at, what should I do? Does that mean I should add m and m together? Because it says plus sign. And of course, the many of you out there, particularly those of you who've done logarithms twice, are screaming, no, no, no. When you add logs, it is really the same thing as multiplying m times n. Now, you may ask yourself, why is that the case? Why on earth, when it says plus, would I multiply? Well, you have to remember that age-old thing, important concept. What do logarithms represent? Of course, you're shouting, logarithms represent exponents. A key concept. So, if logarithms represent exponents, let's think back to our exponent days. What do you get if you take x to the third times x to the eighth? Well, of course, we all know that's x to the 11th. So even though the problem said multiply, you actually added the exponents. Well, since logarithms represent exponents over here, when we have a log plus a log, we're adding the exponents. And when we add exponents, that really means we are in the process of multiplication. So we turn that back into m times n. Same thing is, of course, true with logs when you subtract them. Obviously, if you multiply when you add, then yes, indeed, you divide when you subtract them. Now, be sure you notice that that condenses into one logarithm, the log base b of m over n. Sometimes I have people get confused and think it's the log of m divided by the log of n. That is so wrong. That is not what happens. It becomes one logarithm of m divided by n. So that is a major no-no. Do not do that. In fact, we're going to obliterate it so you won't think about wanting to do that. And finally, the rule of rules, the ultimate one that gives us all the power, that's going to let us solve all those wonderful application problems you have coming in the next few classes. Of course, what can we do when we have a log of some base to a power? Well, as you'll recall, we can move that power and it forms the very famous plog rule, where we pull that power down front and make it p times the log. That is our number one rule for how we're going to solve exponential equations in the next class. So we need to bring it down by using the plog rule. You can actually use that rule both directions. If you have a number down front of a log, you may move it back up and make it the exponent. And that's actually the version of this rule that you will use more on this assignment. Okay, with those three properties in mind, we are now going to go solve some great log equations. Okay, your goal here, when you see a problem that contains multiple logarithms, your goal is you have to get this down to one term on each side of the log. So you have to condense it down using the properties to make to one term on each side. So condense to one term on each side of the equal sign using the properties. Once we get it down to one log on each side, we can do like you just did on your last assignment. We can exponentiate then to get rid of our logarithm. But key thing, condense it to one term on each side. So up here we have a log base 7 of x plus 5 plus a log base 7 of x minus 3. How can I condense that into one logarithm? Well, my property says when you have a log plus a log, you are supposed to multiply. So we are actually going to combine that into 1 log base 7, and we're going to multiply x plus 5 times x minus 3. That's going to give us then, and yes, you said it, we're going to FOIL that, which will give us x squared plus 2x minus 15 when we FOIL it. Okay, on the other side, we also need that condensed to 1 logarithm. Well, you're going, it is one term. But in order to exponentiate it, we can't have that 2 in front. So what am I going to do with that 2? You guessed it. I'm going to use the Plog rule in reverse, and I'm going to move the 2 back up here. So I'm actually making that the log base 7 of 3 squared, or in other words, log base 7 of 9. Now that you actually have each side, one term each side, that's your goal, then your second step is going to be everybody's favorite. You're going to exponentiate. So, what am I exponentiating with? What base am I going to use? Well, since these logs are base 7, yes, we're using 7s. So I'm going to put a 7 underneath this and raise my logarithm up as an exponent. And I'm, of course, going to do the same thing on the other side. I'm going to put a 7 underneath that side as well, which will give me log base 7 of 9. Of course, once I do that, the 7s with the log base 7s will cancel, and we are now left with x squared plus 2x minus 15 equals 9. Now we're down to an ordinary quadratic equation, so yes, set it equal to 0 and solve it. How many of these problems have you solved over the years? That's going to factor very nicely as x plus 6 and x minus 4. And we can now solve for x as being negative 6 and positive 4. Now, the question is, are you done? And the answer is no. You must check to make sure you will have logs with positive values. So that's absolutely essential that you check your answers in the original problem. You don't have to show any work to check it. How are we going to know on a test if you didn't check it? Well, there's going to be some answers that won't check. So if you don't check it, you're going to miss something here. So go back to the original problem. You must check in the original before you did move to anything. So here at the very top, if I stuck negative 6 in for this first x in the x plus 5, would I have the log of a positive number? Answer, no. I wouldn't have the log of a positive number. So negative 6 doesn't work. So we will be crossing out negative 6. Our other answer was 4. So if I put 4 in for x, will 4 plus 5 be positive? Answer, yes. Put it into the next x. Will 4 minus 3 give us a positive number? Yes. So it has to check in every place there was an x. So in this particular problem then, we're going to throw out negative 6. And only 4 is a solution. Now hopefully you're going, oh, I remember this stuff. This is great. Okay, next one. Works the same way with natural logs. Doesn't matter if they're natural or common. And while yes, you have both addition and subtraction, you can do it all in one step. What do we do when two logs are added? We multiply their arguments. We take 4x times 3. But since there's a subtracting of the natural log of 6, subtraction means division, so you can put that in as a big divided by 6, all in one step. Now, do I need to change the other side at all? And the answer is yes. I can't have a 3 out front. When I exponentiate, the 3 will stop it from canceling, so I have to move the 3 back and make it the exponent. Okay, if we simplify that here on the left, 12x divided by 6 will make that natural log of 2x. On the right-hand side, that would be natural log of 64. And now, how am I going to get rid of the logs? You guessed it. I'm going to exponentiate. But the question is, with what base? Well, natural logs are base e logs, so therefore we are going to exponentiate both sides with base e's. And you will have the natural log of 2x, and the natural log of 64, what's going to happen? They're going to cancel. 2x equals 64, and we're down to x equals 32. Are we done? Well, did we have, were our x's part of the logarithm? Go back up to the top. Yes, we only had the 1x, the 4x. If I put a positive 32 in there, will I have the log of a positive number? 4 times 32 is positive, so this answer is good. So, key thing is, always remember to check. So, pull that one over there too. All right, couple others here. You'll notice this is a little different. A, this is common logs. We don't have a base on it. So hopefully we realize that that is indeed a base 10. And we have only a number on the right-hand side. We don't have an actual logarithm. Well, it still works the same way. We'll still exponentiate it out and it'll all be fine. So you still need to get it down to one log on each side. Oh, and shoot. Well, no, this green works okay on black. So we can leave the green here. Alrighty. So if I combine them, log plus a log, I really need to multiply. So I've got x squared plus 3x equals 1. Okay, I'm ready to get rid of the log and I need to exponentiate. The question is, what base do I exponentiate with? Welp, this is base 10, so we're exponentiating with 10s on this one. And so I will have 10 to the log base 10 power. And over here, I'll have 10 to the first power. That's going to cancel. And so we have x squared plus 3x equals 10. Oh golly, it's another quadratic. So subtract 10 over, get it equal to 0. And I believe this one will factor quite nicely as x plus 5 and x minus 2. When you check that out, that should get us a 3x in the middle. And in that case then, x is going to equal negative 5 and positive 2. Are we done? Absolutely not. Yes, we're going to check our answers. Going back to the original problem at the top, we have a negative 5 and a positive 2. If I put negative 5 in for x, is that going to work? I put it right here. No, I can't have the log of negative 5. So negative 5 is out of there. It is not a solution. Is positive 2 going to check? If we go back up, in the first log, positive 2 would be a positive number. Put it in the second log, 2 plus 3 would be positive 5. So that works. So this answer does check. And we have then just an answer of x equals 2. Now, I have some people who assume then that all negative answers are wrong and all positive answers are right. And let me dispel that notion. If you may have a problem where maybe you had 2 minus x. Or actually, let's make that 1 minus x. Okay? If I check, if I put negative 5 in there, negative 5 would have given me 1 plus 1 minus negative 5 would equal 6. So in this case, negative 5 would check. And if I put positive 2 in there, 1 minus 2 would not check. So do not assume that all negative answers are bad and all positive answers are good. It depends on what the quantity is that's inside that log. So needless to say, chances that your test might include some problems that make sure that you have some answers that are negative that work, that's probably a good assumption. Okay, and our last problem, we also need to do this with natural logs here. And once again, you'll notice it's equal to 3. It's not equal to a logarithm, and that's okay. How am I going to get these logs put together? I need one term on each side. Well, what do you do when you have a log minus a log? Yes, you divide it. So I have x plus 2 over 4 inside my natural log. You cannot stop writing log early. If you do, it will mess up your problems. It'll mess up these two problems perfectly. Let me make my point. If I didn't write a log And I just say, if you get lazy, and that's what happens. People get lazy, they won't write log. Now you think this fraction is equal to 3. And when you go to solve it, you're going to get a totally incorrect answer. Because if there's a natural log sitting there, next step is I have to get rid of the natural log by exponentiating. You will exponentiate every single problem. And if you don't have log there, you're not going to remember to exponentiate. So what am I exponentiating with? Well, yes, since this is base e, we're going to exponentiate both sides with base e. And we'll have e to the natural log of x plus 2 over 4 power equals e cubed. Of course, the e and the natural log will cancel. We're going to be left with x plus 2 over 4 equals e cubed. That's substantially different than what you would have had if you had this equal to 3. So do not get lazy and stop writing your logarithms. Okay, now, how do I solve for x? Well, I need to get rid of the 4. So I'm going to times both sides by 4 and get the fraction to cancel. That will give me x plus 2 equals 4e cubed. And then I want to solve for x. So I am going to subtract that over and get 4e cubed minus 2. Now, these kind of problems are not going to come out with nice answers. So you will have to put them into your calculator and get an approximate value. I think that your answers are rounded to 2 decimal places, so this one would round to 78.34. But you should expect some decimal answers, particularly when you're working with e and natural logs. That, folks, is the exciting and fun-filled life of solving logarithmic equations. Next up, we'll be solving exponential equations using logarithms, and we'll be putting the plug rule to work extensively. So have a great time and enjoy being logarithmic.